Elizabeth Craft Designs. It's Happy Friday again. It feels like I just said that yesterday. The time is going by so fast. Maybe because I had so much fun with the new collection. So first of all, it arrived in Europe. So it was this afternoon. So we start shipping on Monday to the stores in Europe as well. So super excited about that. We don't have all the boxes yet, but enough to start shipping. So and the rest should arrive on Monday. Don't know if it's true, but it should. So we're so that is a happy Friday because yeah, very happy that it's there. So whimsical winter collection from Josette. I don't know if you saw this morning. I posted a little. Did I only do a picture or did I turn around? Like I'm going to make show you how to make an ornament out of the. Out of that gnome, and super fun, and this is just the beginning because I have lots of things in my head. I don't know if Lisanne is already here, but you know she had the wrecking ball at one point with one of her, with one of the characters. So with the Christmas collection, with the Christmas special, and then ornaments, and then I thought, oh, you know, a gnome ornament. But I know Lisanne can make a wrecking ball gnome as well. So that was a fun idea, and combining it with the snowflakes. I know Joseph did something yesterday. I think he made a dress for the girl with the snowflakes on it. So lots and lots of ideas. So I will have a fun weekend ahead of me for sure. So I want to say, let's turn the camera on because I'm going to show you the collection quickly for the people that missed it. And then I'm going to start making the ornaments. So the collection from Josette. Oh, and let's see the comments here as well. Let's see, I'm here. That works well. I see Wilma, Laura, Paulette, and Susan, Patricia, Rave. And of course, comment and share. Hi, Ruli, Marjan, and a lot of other people, but I don't see all the names anymore. But Sir Stampalot, I know you ordered already, so feel free, people can call you, or feel free if there's stores here, feel free to put the link in to your website so people can order from you. I know, I am very happy that it is in our warehouse right now. So Mary, Suzanne, hi everybody. So, okay, eagerly waiting, I know. Let's fingers crossed for you, fingers crossed. collection. So basically it's six dies. So we have the gnomes and I'm going to show you all the parts and super easy to put together. So, and I have here all the ones you see that you can put together and I show them in the video from Wednesday. They're also online already for you to see. Of course, you always get ideas on the packaging. If you have the gnomes, don't forget our wonderful, wonderful mushroom house because they go super fun together, of course. So don't forget that you can do a small one. Like I had this one in the picture. I know I put him behind here somewhere, kind of half in the door. So super fun. So don't forget the mushroom with this one. So those are the gnomes. And then, of course, I made my box. And let me put these away so I can show them again later. But so this one, and somebody posted online in an answer said, oh, I'm going to make the ornaments and then put them in a box. And it was in a pizza box. That was exactly my idea this morning as well. Because if you have the ornament, because this is what I'm going to show you. And it's super easy, of course, there's only two parts that you kind of need to do different, but you know, it's easy. So make a super fun box. Hi, Marga, Ellie, Suzanne, hi. So you see, so here, if you have the box and you give that as a present and put some ornaments in there, how cool would that be as a gift? That is just so much fun. So I'm absolutely, this is the one from many more to come. I probably stay in these colors because I'm a very, you can call that boring as well. I'm very traditional in colors. It's always gold and green. And so for me, it's probably going to be in those colors. Hi, Kathleen and Anya. Phil, hi, from Brooklyn, Ontario, Canada. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. Yeah, they're really, really nice. And then I have some small wobblers as well, which will be fun. You can put them on there and then, you know, so much fun ideas. And then this one, so my idea for the ornament started with this one, because this one I wanted to make on a slimline cut. So this one is actually one-sided, But then I got the idea, how cool would it be? So I was going to hang this, but I didn't. I was going to hang this one on here, like on a background like this. But, you know, so gnomes galore for me for sure. So I'm going to put these back in here for now. I'm going to put them aside so I don't lose them. And then I'm going to make another box for my parts because I need that as well. Hi, Klein. So Klein Sprite, I know that's not your first name. I just put your Klein Sprite. I just put your the note I have here with my bag, so I can email the Netherlands to ship you that collection for free because you won that last week. So the gnomes. Then we got the train, and I already saw like the first response to that one. That's going to be fabulous, and that is another idea that I want to do. So we have the holiday train. So there's probably going to be something for Monday. And the train cards. And my idea is, well, you can make the train cards, of course. I have something like stacked. Yeah, I have something in my mind for on a slimline card. So I think that's going to be fun. The whole tree with only gnomes would be nice. Oh yeah, Yona, for sure. A small tree then, because I don't have time to make them all. But it's definitely, you know, you have those places on your tree that are really inside. So those will have the gnomes, and then with the ornaments, and then on the back, it's like the ornaments you don't like that much. That's how it goes, isn't it? Yeah, so the train sets, but what I told earlier, these will make great packages. So you can already imagine that if I do a package, it's kind of in my head, and I open the lids, a gnome can be sticking out. So there's so many ideas, and I know we have a fantastic design team as well. So you might see it already, but yeah, some little mushrooms. Yeah, these ones, the gnomes in like fall colors will be great in your TN. Great in your TN. So I made the winter one in here, but you know, did I do it in this one? I don't even know. Oh, it's not in this one. Oh, it's in a new one. But in this one, because this is but I have the rectangle one. So if you do it in fall colors in here, I have four colors felt that will be fantastic as well. And I also have different colors of wool because I did this one, but I'll show you that in a sec. Let's do the collection first. You see, my head is overloaded with ideas. But and I love what Jose did here. So the lights and then the separate lights. So if you cut that out of with tape on the back, cardstock with tape, you can do all the different lights very easily, what she did here. Yeah, lots and lots of ideas. Okay, so that one, the train. Then we have those beautiful slim lines. And let me get the dotted one here, the dotted background, this one. You see that's used here. And that was my idea with the hanging one. So slim line. And then, you know, if I pick him up, you can see it here. This was my idea with that one. So he's going to hang from the card here. With probably a thinner twine, but that was kind of the idea. I thought that would be super cool. So that's that one. And I have another one here from Anita. And then really in girly colors. So that is super cool. Hi, Lisanne. I was just talking, Lisanne. I don't know if you just arrived. I'm waiting for your wrecking ball with a gnome on it, Lisanne. I think that will be so much fun. Then the backgrounds. So that's this one, the Slimline Adventure Edges backgrounds. Those are actually 8.5 inch. So you can trim them, of course, to any size. But love that with a few florals in there. But of course, you can make that into a winter scenery as well, because that's what I did with this one. So here I used the edges. You see, I used the fence. I used this part and I added some snow to that. So that's, so, you know, everything connecting. And then this one is the winter scenery. So that's this one. And that's that one. And this one I did with snow on it as well. And like I had the little rabbits here, or, you know, and here the wolf and the fox. Yeah. Fun, fun, fun. Fun, fun, fun. So let's put this away. And then I'm going to start my ornaments. And if I have time, I will do a girl and a boy. I still have coffee. Mark made me coffee. I didn't drink that one yet. So I have all the parts done. And what I want to do is I want to do show the face quickly. Because if you missed that on Wednesday. And then I'm going to show you how to put it together. And I only did one so far. So I'm absolutely sure that I will change things later, but this will give you the idea for sure. I need to add some red to that. So basically what you do, I cut the face and all the hands out of white soft finish. I did cut extra hands here. I have quite a few hands there. Because depending on which sleeve you use, because if you look at this one, you see you have here the sleeve, so you can do different, you can build it different ways. So if you do like bend the arm and then one stretching out, they both need the same hands because the thumb is going the same way then. I don't know if I said it correct, but that's what it is. Hi, Angelique. Did you all watch the news, of course, again in the Netherlands, my goodies. Okay, so what is next? So I'm going to color these. And then you can see with, I'm using the tea dye for the face. You can also use tatted rose. I think that's what Josette does. But I didn't not have any refill for tatted rose. And this is our soft finish cardstock. And I just refilled this one, so then you also always get a little bit of a stronger, do you need a hand? Yeah, you need, I definitely need a hand. I had a meeting this morning, so it was super busy. So I was late at the office for the live, but you know, we're here. So just see if I have a little bit same, but of course it's good that it's, you know, it's going to be front and back. So that's with the face, and then I'm going to add some red there. And with these ones, I just, the hands, I just dab. Like, dab, dab, dab. There's no shading on that. So kind of go back and forth till you think it has the correct color. And then the nose, I can make a little bit red as well. Oh, Jennifer, new rules, new COVID rules. It's not going the right direction there. So, new COVID rules, you know. It's kind of, it's getting old by now, like it's, you know, it's just how it goes. Back and forward, because we need to have our, you know, need to be enough staff to take care of the people. So this one, and then put that there. And then this one, I'm going to add a little bit of the red. So I'm using the fired brick for that one. See, I like the rosy cheeks for the winter, And then these ones I also need, so I use a fired brick for this. And the rosy cheeks almost disappear if you make the men variant of the gnome. But it just needs to do. Okay, and now I need my PN. So what I do, and I told that on Wednesday, so there are embossed lines in the eye. So what I do, I take my Micron PN with a plastic nib. And then I go in a black one, and then I go in and I kind of circle the embossed line, and then I color it in inside. Because then I know that I'm kind of okay. So I circle the embossed line, and then I color in inside. You see, so now I have my noses, I'm going to color a few noses as well, because definitely I like that to have a little bit of the red. So this is just a little bit of etching with that red there. So it has the rosy nose as well, a cold nose. Hi, Connie. That's fine. You can always watch back, eh? And it actually streams to YouTube right away as well. So if you have friends that don't watch, that don't have Facebook, tell them they can see Elizabeth Craft Designs on YouTube as well. And I know like Esther, she does a live now in Dutch every Tuesday, if she's at home, of course. Or she does it even on the road as well. But Esther does lives on YouTube now because she had so much trouble with Facebook. So if you find Esther on YouTube, she will be there on YouTube. And it will actually have a translation underneath because it's in Dutch. It will have translation underneath, but it is, I think it takes a little while for it to be there. I don't know exactly, but it will be there for sure. I need to clean my hands, get my red ink for my finger, because otherwise I have red ink on my beard or on anything else from the gnome. So these are ready to go. Okay, so now I need to get myself a sheet, a non-stick sheet. Here I have one. a brown one that's from a paper. So let me go through the parts quickly. So you have the face and hands and the nose. That's what I just did. Then you have the head, two different directions, like hanging and standing up. So those are actually symmetric. So what I did with those, I'm going to show you as I talk about it. So those are cut both from the front side. So my die went on the felt part and run it through. So those are symmetric. So when I want to put those together, what I'm going to do, you see they line up perfectly. So you can do those like that. Then you have the antlers. The antlers are symmetric as well. So I have those cut out of the wood with the tape on the back. And you can line those up perfectly. So you can put your die on the front of that one. Then the beard. Shoes are all symmetric. These are symmetric. Well, those are symmetric. So those will line up perfectly. The only thing that is not symmetric are pretty sure the pigtails as well. Yeah, the pigtails are not symmetric. But the beard, you see there's a difference between this side and this side. So what I did with that one, one I put my die on the front and one I put my die on the back. And you can see it. I will bring it up because then you can see clearly that there is an embossed line on this beard. You see? So you see the line from the die. So one I put the die on the wool. The other one I put the die on the back. What I do then, when I die cut with the wool on the plate, and then my die cut on here, then I take a piece of release sheet or white paper or whatever to put it on there. And then you put your die on there. Reason why is, so basically I have a piece here. Let me show you. So this is white cardstock with tape and the wool on there. So if I need to die cut from this side, because you need to do that if you want to kind of line it up perfectly, then I take a piece of protective sheet and put it underneath there. Reason for that is that your wool, your plates might be dirty and you don't want to have that on your white beard or on your cardstock or anything that you're using. Do we have signal issues? Yeah, I have no idea. I hope it's, you can see in here. Okay, alrighty. So that's that one. We have the clothing, and that's the other one. So this one as well, so this part, that's not symmetrical as well. So I did die cut that. You can here see, I can see the imprints there from the die. So I die cut it once from the front, from the felt, and one from the paper side. So then it lines up perfectly. So basically the beard with the moustache and the dress or the clothing, you need to die cut from two sides to have it perfectly lined up. So let's start building it up. I hope I do it correct because it's, as I say, I did it once so far. And I have to tell one thing more what I did. Let me see. Got this one, this one. I got two faces. I'm just going to kind of gather my pieces, two faces, two noses, one, two, there we go. And the hands I just leave because I don't know which arms I'm going to use yet. So I can put these together already. So let's do that because they're going to be in between the two heads. So this one and these both have tape on there because it's just how my wood was. This kind of a wood that you can use. So you see two sides wood now for that one. So again, these are symmetrical. So you can just put, die cut them both the same. Are we good again with, I see people are watching. So you're good. Better feed than Facebook. YouTube is a better feed than Facebook today. Okay, so you can go to YouTube as well. If you go, Mark, can you put in a link to the YouTube channel? That we can, that people, if they have issues here on Facebook, that you can actually go to the YouTube channel. You see, but it also, that proves that it's most of the time it has to do with Facebook. Facebook is not always helping. Okay, so let's get started. I need to think as well. So if I want to put the dress together, I'm going to start with this one, with the heads. So I'm going to add my glue here. And again, next time I might do it differently, but because I did one yesterday. And so I do some glue here. There is no tape on the back of these ones. And I might try to cut it with tape as well. But so far, I did it without the tape. So that felt is actually, the felt is felt on tape. And then on a thin piece of paper. In this case, it is a craft paper. You see, so there's double-sided adhesive between the felt and the paper. Reason for that is if you just die cut felt, it will fall apart. It's flimsy. By adding a thin piece of paper, it just makes it much easier. Okay, so now if I want to line this up, but I'm just going to build this one first. And, well, I can actually do that right away, I guess. Just thinking, this, there's nothing in between there. Yeah, okay. You see, I need to think as well. So if I turn around this one, but I want to have the antlers in between. So that's what I'm going to do first. I'm going to put those antlers in between the heads. So this one is going here. And then that one, you see, you really need to think what you're doing, because otherwise you forget a step and you can always, correct it. But then you need to tear it apart. I think that's actually what I did yesterday with hands or something. I forgot the hands. Okay, so that's in between already. That's good. Then I'm going to line up that face. So this one, and I probably could have cut this one then with tape on the back. But in this case, it's not. So I'm just going to line that up. Put it on here. Then the other head is going on there. Then I have my first step. And again, you can imagine as well, and I do this with felt because I just love the look of that. But if you want to do it just paper with the kits or something, that's super cool as well. You see, so now I have this one. Going to press it down, perfectly lined up already. Then I'm going to do what I'm going to do. So the dress first. I think I need to decide. Yeah, because I can put the hands under the beard. Ta-ta-ta-ta. Did I cut hands already? I did cut some hands, but not enough. I need to cut some extra hands. So beard, I can put it on if I only put glue there. But now I need to put the dress on first. And I'm only going to put a little bit of glue here now. Just like there. Doing the same on the other side. So I can add hands in between if I want to. And as soon as I know exactly what I'm doing, then it's easier. But I just want to be careful now. So don't glue that together. So again, so this one is cut from the paper side and from the felt side because it's not even. Same with the beard. Cut from the paper side and cut from the wool side. If you're just jumping in, I explained it earlier so you can find that. You could use... Exactly. Suzanne, that's correct. You can do different colors. And for the wool, so I showed you that. So I had that. This one was, I got it in a craft store. I'm pretty sure this is not real. This is synthetic, I guess. This one is very old wool from Josette. I don't have that color. You know, she made those dolls, like the fairies kind of stuff when she was little. And this is real wool. And when I run that through... That is this one as well. It was really flat and you could hardly see its wool anymore. But it's actually, you know, it came to life again by itself. So now it really looks like a beard again. So, but that was kind of fun to see. Okay, so now I have this one. I need to get rid of my glue. Going to put this one here. And because on the other one, like this one, I didn't have like both sides. So that was actually harder to line up a bit. But now I think I should have it correct. So that this one, like there, just under the eyes. like that. And then a nose. That one. But you can see clearly, like this you can do for hours. Yeah, this is really fun to make because they are so adorable. That one. Okay. So are we still good on sound, Mark? Is it working? Yeah? Not ideal. Not ideal, I see. I know, Beverly. Yeah. And you can buy that. I had a lot of felt because of those dolls that Josette created. I got a lot of real wool felt. And wool felt is a little bit like your paper from your scrapbooking or whatever. It's, you know, when you have really nice paper that you think, oh, that's so, you know, I cannot touch that yet. That's what I have with wool felt because it looks so nice and all the colors are so nice. So the felt I have at home, well, Josette is 38. Well, that felt must have been like 25 years old, I guess, about. Crazy, isn't it? Crazy what we save. Crazy what we save. Okay. So that's that. So cute. Okay, little nose. Just going to see where the comments... I'm way behind, isn't it? Oh, yeah, I see her all there. This one on here. I pressed it down a bit. Can't wait. I know Tom and Annika are coming with Christmas. They will love it. I probably need to do some more. There you go. Okay, so now the shoes. So the shoes are going in between here. So that's one of the reasons why you need to leave this open. You see, so this now is open because the shoes are going in between there. And then I need to do the arms. But I should do the arms first. Wait, if I have... I don't have enough arms, so I need to cut two more if I want to use those. Let me get my felt out. I still have enough for arms. So you see, this one is again, it's the felt. And then with the tape in the back and just a thin piece of paper. And the arms is this piece. So do I just have enough space. You see, I'm just going to cut those so I can use those. And then, of course, you also have the, like, the circle one. So the, like, just kind of a, that they can hold it. Did I use that as well? Yeah, but this one, you see? I just used, like, the little, these ones. Those are arms as well. But these are more like sleeves. So if I want these, I need to, do I have, yeah, I should have enough now. That's that. And of course, advice is put your pieces back right away because otherwise you lose them. Okay, so I have two of these. So I can use this and this because that goes together. And again, these line up perfectly. So that's. And then I need to see that I have this one. And then I need this one for that. Yeah, so that's that. And then which shoes am I going to use? I'm going to use the natural ones. I have those there. So I did not use these ones in here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And these actually have tape on the back. Do we have 2 and 2? Let's see. I think I have. So basically, yeah, they both have tape. In this case, one with tape would be enough. But sometimes I just cut them with tape. I cut them all with tape on the back. So that's hi Terry, Kathy. By Christmas, yes. And let me tell you something about that because you know we live on the mountain. So besides we need to be careful with COVID, of course, the baby cannot come on the mountain for at least 2 or 3 months, Mark. Is it? Yeah, for at least 2 or 3 months because of the lungs. Because we live at 10,000 feet, which is 3,000 meters, about the highest mountain we went to in Austria to ski. And the air, it's very thin air. I said it correct, eh? Thin air? Yeah. So that's not, for the baby, it's not good. So we need to go down the mountain to see the baby, which is fine, of course, because his lungs need to, it's a boy, if I didn't say that yet, it's a boy. And because the lungs need to develop, you know, need to get stronger. So this is going to be in between there. So I'm going to glue these. No, I can actually hide this. Oh, wait, that's that side. And that side. Okay, so I'm going to hide these. And in this case, I can hide them under the beard, I guess. I would move, you know. Suzanne, I that's actually... We're not going to make that before December, but we might move to be closer. Yeah, we're actually thinking about that. Oh, I need to put this here, the glue. Don't get distracted, Els. Don't get distracted. Oh, I can put it under the beard. Wait. I'm just going to put it under the beard. There we go. Yeah, so we're actually thinking about that. Because Denver is a cool city. It would be ages since we've lived in a city. And now this one I'm going to do, oh, only the top, because the hands need to go in there. Oh, Diane, you can watch back, eh? It is on YouTube as well. Okay, wait, else focus, focus. So this needs to go under here. You see now, I need to pull back that beard a little bit because I glued it down too much. There we go. Oh, I think I am not lined up correct. I am, and I can add a little bit of glue there as well. So this now is still open because the hands will go in there. So now I need two hands. Now I need to turn around myself with the thumb down. So this one, and then the other one is up. No, also down. Let me see how that lines up. No, that's wrong. That's the wrong one. Then do I have a correct one? I should have a correct one. Let me see, let me see, let me see. You see, get so this one, is this one going down? No, I know. Oh, this one is the correct one. That's what I mean with the hands, you know, it's it is kind of hard to kind of see what I need to do. Here we go. So add glue, and again, this could be easy with I know, Femke, for sure, but we are in Colorado, eh? So nature is everywhere. I tell you a story. So my sister lives in Calgary in Canada, and you don't see moose a lot. Like a moose is hard to see, you know, you don't see that much. And then she did something for the election, kind of a watcher or whatever in Canada. Not too long ago. And then she was in a neighborhood and she saw two moose in the schools, and she saw two moose walking by. And then the people sitting there, they said, oh, you know, they are here all the time. So 5 minutes from her house, there's a moose, there a group of moose living there. There we go. I want to have that hand in there a little bit more. There we go. You see, so that one. Shoes, and the other arms are going to go in there. Yeah, but how could it is a puzzle, but honestly, it's a, you know, and it's a puzzle because I talk and try to do things at the same time, which I'm normally very good at because we're women, we can do two things at the same time. But because this is new to me as well, I need to think. You can actually leave his hand there, or you can bring it here. So if you bring it up here, you see, so you just glue it underneath there then. And then the other side. Oh, then I can put glue under the hole. Yeah, on this one. And this one is going. Never saw a moose. Now, Femke, a moose is very impressive, I have to say. Because elk, I tell you, because I was on my way here. I was late already. And then on my way here, I had a traffic stop. And I thought, oh, what's going on? I hope it's not an accident or whatever. And then it's a big group of elk just roaming. I had an elk walking past my car, like literally if I would have opened my window I could have touched it, because there's a ton of elk in Evergreen and they just walk everywhere. So there was a big group of elk. So elk is very common, although not on the mountain this year, but in Evergreen there's a ton. There we go. But yeah, so now that one is left hand, so thumbs up for that one. You see, that's why you need to make a whole thing of So this one I can put glue on because that's, oh no, a little bit of glue here as well, because it's going under the sleeve. And before I'm done, I can do this eyes closed. So I put this down the hand with glue. If I want to have a gift underneath, I should not have the glue all the way there. So that's done. And then on this side, a hand. So that one is the right hand. So there's also a thumbs up there. That's this one then. I'm turning around the whole time. You don't see that, but I'm turning around to see. I'm turning myself around to see where the thumb needs to be. So this one as well, glue here and a little bit of glue here because it's going under the sleeve. I think I'm doing pretty well, pretty well. I don't know if I'm going to do the girl as well. I might do that at home. But how super cute is that? So now I still think this one I should have pressed down a little bit more underneath there. I can just snip it off as well, but I think it's fine. And then we have the shoes left. So the shoes are already glued together. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put a little bit of glue in between there. Yeah, nice, eh, Focaline? Yeah, I think so too. Yeah, yeah, it is. Yeah, I know there's several stores. Most of the stores, I know most of the stores in the Netherlands ordered already. And in the US, we are shipping already. I don't know if they received it already, the stores, but, and this one is, so there, I just, you see, I'm going to try if I can cut this with tape on the back, because that would be so much easier, but now I'm just going to kind of glue those shoes in there, and this one this way, and press it down. There we go. Da-da-da-da. And now I think I should have, you see, now I get the situation that I have my glue everywhere again. So that is that one. And then let me see if I can still, because we have the, you know, we have the ornaments, which is super cool. Because on that same set, so this is from the gifts, because the gifts had some fun stuff. Then on the gnome itself, on the gnome itself, we have the ornaments. And then a zigzag line can go on there. And then we have a gift with wrapping as well. And then, of course, we have the little piggy tails, but there we go. So this one is tape on the back, so you can line it up here. You see, so you can give him an ornament. And you can give one an ornament and the other one not. That is fine. Let me do that. So I'm going to give one side an ornament and the other one not. But then I'm not going to glue down at the top because maybe I'm going to try to kind of put a little bit of twine underneath it. And I know I glued those hands down, but I can slide it underneath there. There you go. You see, so he is holding his ornaments. Then I need to put a little bit of glue down there again. So you can give them something or you can have them holding hands. That's what I did with the other, like with the one on the box. So this needs a little bit of glue, but just a tiny bit, because otherwise it's going to smudge on the silver for sure. And just press that down. But now my idea is I will do that at home because I don't have that here, but this needs a little hole and then a little piece of twine. Do I have thin twine here? No, that's not thin enough. I need to have really thin twine to kind of, no, that's not thin enough. No. I need to do that at home. Probably going to do a little pokey hole in here and then a little twine. I think that will be fun. How cool is this? So now the top piece. So the top piece is from the ornaments kit. So I took my ornaments out. But you can imagine that you can play with the snowflakes as well. Like snowflake on the dress. Maybe I'll, you know, let me see how far it gets. So that's that. And then I'm using the top pieces from the ornaments. I took my ornaments out. I think I'm going to do gold in this case. So I take two. Yeah, two with tape on the back. Tape on the back. And that will be my top piece. And to do that, I snipped a little piece of the top because otherwise, you know, it's going to be, you see, it sticks out too much on the side. So I snipped off a little bit of his head. Yeah. Oh, for Christmas cookies. Let me show you because we have one like that. Anita made one. Here. We have one with a spoon. Where's the spoon? The spoon is from the kettle, from the Halloween set, I think, from the cooking kettle, from the accessories. So I snip off, I think, this part. And then I have tape on here, but I'm also, here we go. I think I might, no, I think it will, oh, that's already there. See, and then you put this here. So all the four kind of pins are on the felt because I don't like it when they stick out. That, and then you do the same on this side. See? Yeah, there is, yeah, there's really nice felt. Yeah, you need to look at, I know that there are companies like that, that make the little elves, like those, oh, I don't know how you call that. I can look it up, but probably if you just Google Wolfeld, the Netherlands, you will find it. But they have also those companies, they also have those little, they make those little packages that you can make babies and whatever, all kind of stuff from felt or mobiles, how do you call that? Something you hang above the bed from, you know, they're all kind of, or fairy tales kind of thing. There we go, you see? And now I have my twine to put on there. I know I have that somewhere, the gold. Oh, here. And then I can put that on there. See? There we go. Yeah, the gray beard. Yeah, that, so that's what I say. That's the real wool. But in the stores market, I don't know where you are. In Europe, we just started shipping. We start shipping on Monday. They just came through the door. But in the US, we are shipping already. We shipped already. So I don't know exactly, because you know we cannot predict shipping these days. But I know we shipped quite a few orders out already here. So they are here. They are in our warehouse and shipping to stores right now. Okay, so that is it. And I honestly think that I'm going to do the girl at home. I have to tell you, you know, for this one, for both these two, for the people that don't have felt at hand right away, this is, both these are Swiffers. So white cardstock, the double-sided adhesive. Of course, we have those rolls of double-sided adhesive, these or sheets or whatever you want to use. I have that. I put that on the white cardstock. And then I add the Swiffer to that. So those Swiffer things. And those are actually, those two are both from Swiffers. And for the beard, I know people talked about waterbolletjes. How do you call that? Pompons, like, I don't know what waterbolletjes are in English. But the one that you clean your face with, your makeup or something. I don't know that name because I don't wear makeup. Yeah, I only have stuff for every now and then when I put nail polish on. But yeah, so that is, you can try that for the beard. And I also bought this one because this will be cool to kind of make a little forest scenery. And that's from the mason jar. Also fun, 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 fun. I already saw somebody making a page. It must be somebody from the design team then. It made a page with the gnome on the front for the first page. Cotton balls. Thank you, Jonah and RJ. Yeah. I forgot about it. Yeah, I could not get the name. So I will bring these, you know, I will bring my gnomes up for you to see. Just a second. And of course, I will take a picture as well. So let me get a nice sheet of colored cardstock so I can actually show it to you. Because they are adorable. And I am in love. And the dots that you see on the box here, on the pizza box, is actually from the dotted background. Oh, I should only do the dolls, because otherwise they are. Ah, look at that. He's reaching out, you see. Oh, this one is reaching out, you see. So he can hold hands. But again, and decorate, you have all those fun little elements that you can use. There we go. Aren't those adorable? They are so cute. They are so cute. So get out your stash, go through your craft room, and you will find all the different materials you can use. You can use for this. And since, you know, they try to, in the Netherlands, they want you to go outside, but you know, you can, of course, but these are not available yet. So Monday, they will ship. Doing might pick them up. I don't know, but anytime, of course, check out your local store and they will have this for you. So let's turn the camera around, Mark. And then there we are again. So I want to thank you all for watching. What time is it? I'm a little bit, 15 minutes early. Yeah, it would not be enough to make a girl. I will absolutely make a gnome girl and put that on the Elizabeth Craft Designs Facebook page. Of course, we have Elizabeth Craft Designs family for you to post as well. We also have ECD planners and journaling. And then Ilse and Charlene have journal with us. So kind of for every category, we have something for you to share your art with. Of course, check us out on Instagram as well. And this Facebook Live streams to YouTube right away. So you can subscribe to the YouTube channel because sometimes that works apparently better. And also tell your friends about it, that if they don't want to watch on Facebook, they can watch on YouTube as well. So I want to wish you all, it's beautiful weather here. I have to say it's beautiful weather. So I want to wish you all a wonderful, wonderful weekend. And I'll see you on Monday. Bye-bye.